हरि ही ओ गणपतये नमः ॐ गुं गुरुभ्यो नमः ॐ ऐं सरस्वत्यै नमः। There was once a young lad who lived in a village, and adjacent to his house there was a temple. He used to love God only for a prasad and for ringing the bells, but his love for divine was innocent and unknowing. He used to revere the installed deity of the temple and pray, "O God, grant me whatever I want and whenever I want." One day, the Lord, much pleased with his guileless and open-hearted devotion, appeared in his dream and asked, "Do you want to enjoy your wishes up to the time of pensionable age, or a happy and carefree mendicant's life?" Due to the inherent delusion, the boy said, "My Lord, I prefer the former." The Lord granted it, and his joy knew no bounds. Once he prayed for good education without any impediments, and it was readily granted. Again he asked for all delicious food to enjoy in life, and the Lord said, "Be it so, you will have them now at this very second." For the third time, he wanted to enjoy wife and children, and the merciful Lord sanctioned that too. Years roll on thus. The more the desires were fulfilled, the more he used to ask, and finally, when the age of superannuation approached, he prayed his dear Lord that he wanted to release life to his heart's content before leaving the body, as there was still residue of sensual enjoyment left in his mind. Then the Lord granted that wish also to be fulfilled. He was then leading a reckless, dissipated life without knowing, day or night in sensual pleasures, and hence suffered from an incurable disease. There is none to approach him or help him, and the age of superannuation just greeted him with cursed days. Fifth, he wept and wailed, and finally resolved to make an end to his life by jumping down the breeze far from his village with the flowing river underneath. In the dead of night, while he was groping in darkness, he cursed himself for not having chosen the second option. He was ready to jump down recklessly in a fraction of a second when he felt a strong, irresistible backward pull from behind. There was none to be seen to the right or to the left or to the back. On turning round in a fit of disgust and utter disappointment, he saw a blazing fire at a distance. Now there was a magnetic pull towards the fire. He felt inwardly that somebody was calling out to him. He now directed his steps towards the fire. As he was fast approaching, unmindful of his own self, there was light greater and greater in intensity of brightness as he paced each step forward. The more he walked, the more distant it seemed. It was nearing dawn. When finally he approached the spot, the fire disappeared, and an anchorite from inside the cottage with a shining lustrous face appeared and said, "Oh my boy, life is not for deliberate death. How ignorant you are to try to make an end of yourself. Give up such idea. Did I not give you the option on that night to choose fruition of desires or desire-proof ascetic life? you could not reason out that the secret of fulfillment of desires lies in utter renunciation thereof. I pity you now. Go to the yonder rivulet and have your bath. It is now Brahma Murta. Come back. I shall initiate you into knowledge of Brahman, by which you will shine as bliss absolute. So saying, the sadhu sent him away to the rivulet and then disappeared. On return, the old man found out none, neither the cottage nor the anchorite, except a hansadanda, a kamandalu, and a cowpin, and a deerskin, all in om beside a pit of fire, with none around. He searched in vain and was at his wit's end as to what to do next. Then a voice from above said, "Sweet beloved self, I help those in distress, wherever they may be, by my resplendent effulgence. The fire you saw from the breeze is myself. I am in you, I am with you, and I am around you. Fear not, remember me ever. I shall guide you unto me. There is nothing for you to shrink. I know what is passing in your mind. Now, I want to make you one with me, the fire of effulgence you saw." Now the person could realize that it is all Lord's will. The ambulance present there and took sannyas to repeat Om, and he became one with Om. This is the ultimate aim of life, to meditate on Om and to realize our own self and be free from all the trammels of life. Hari Om Tat Sat.